Welcome. I'm so excited we're all here at Imagination Station again. Together, we're going to discover some super cool things. We're going to have a blast today. But before we get started, I need you to grab 2 spoons from your kitchen, just 2 regular spoons. Feel free to ask an adult for help if you need. You will also need the piece of string and your thingamabob from your white day two bag. I'll wait a minute while you gather your supplies. I have an important question for you. Who remembered their imagination today? Uh-oh. Well, sometimes we forget. That's okay. It's only day two. I kind of thought that might happen. So I asked my friend Ruby the macaw for her ideas. I think you already met Ruby, right? Well, she told me something very interesting. Did you know that God is so amazing that God gave macaws like Ruby a special call that they use to celebrate each day when the sun rises and then again when it sets? Isn't that amazing? I wonder, what would it be like if we celebrated every time the sun rose and every time it set? When I count to 3, let's close our eyes and imagine we're macaws like Ruby out in a huge rainforest, sitting high up in a tree, waiting for the sunrise. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Close your eyes. Listen carefully and try to imitate the sounds you hear. Wow. You guys would make some great macaws. Well, now that our imaginations are back on call, let's get moving. How long do you think macaws can live? Do you think macaws like Ruby can live up to 8 years? Or up to 80 years? Okay, let's make a drum roll so I can reveal the amazing answer. And the answer is, macaws can live up to 80 years. In fact, they can outlive their human owners when they live in captivity. Wow. Well, with all that macaw celebrating and calling, I can tell that your ears are tuned up and ready to listen. So let's try something that'll make us think about sound. When you look at this strange contraption, you might wonder what it has to do with sound. But here's something interesting. Sound is actually vibration that passes an object into our ears. Our ears pick up that vibration and our brains translate that into sound. And just like we hear sounds of different things in the world around us, God hears you too.
You are treasured.
That was kind of clangy and not really impressive, right? Let's try something different now. Take your spoon, one of your spoons, and your string. Tie your string to a spoon and wrap the end of the string around each of your pointer fingers. And then lean forward. Now, I know it's silly, put the tips of your 4 fingers just inside your ears, so the spoon dangles and the string is touching your ears. Ask someone around you to clang the dangling spoon with another spoon, and then clang the spoon again. You might want to try this a few times so you can remember what it sounds like. I'll give you a minute or two to try this. Did you hear the clang a bit louder? Sound is actually vibration energy. When something makes a sound, it gives off vibration energy that travels through the air or even a substance. For instance, if you're underwater, sound vibration travels through the water and reaches your ears. If you're outside, sound vibration travels through the air. When it travels through the air, it's not very loud, maybe. But when it travels through our string, the vibration is much stronger. That's why it sounds different. Your ears absorb that vibration, and then your brain translates it. Sound vibration is kind of fun to experiment with. Today's Sciencey Fun Gizmo lets us play even more with vibration energy in a really surprising way. I'm excited to show you. Today we're discovering that God hears you.
You are treasured!
If you're like me, you know how it feels when it seems no one's listening to you. Or maybe it feels like what you say doesn't really matter. Or maybe others don't notice us. But God always hears us. When we're happy or sad, or we need help or advice, God is always listening. We can pray to God any time we want. And just like our friend Ruby, we can call out our praise to God when we celebrate God's awesomeness. Today's Sciencey Fun Gizmo is also awesome, and it's a great reminder that God always hears us. This is called a sing-a-ma-bob. You won't believe how this works. Watch and listen. Wow, I'm going to do that again. Wow! Do you know what I did different that time? I twisted it and then I moved my hands in and out a little. Remember, sounds are vibration energy. The holes in this plastic piece create vibration energy when we whirl it through the air. Let's see if I can do that again. Gotta wind it up. Wow! Now it's your turn. You can experiment with your sing-a-ma-bob. First, I want to tell you, when you take it out of the bag, you're going to notice it's kind of all tied up. Don't worry. Hold on to the two orange rings in one hand and pull the orange plastic in the other. And it will untie very easily. Then twirl it around so it all spins up and pull to make it. Wow, I can hear a little noise there, but let's see. Pull, twist it up and then pull. And wow, not doing very well this time. So you know, it might take a little practice. But as you play with your sing-a-ma-bob, you can be reminded that God hears you.
You are treasured!
No matter what sounds we make, loud, quiet, happy, or sad, we can always trust that God hears us. God loves us so much, and God loves it when we talk to Him. We can talk to God about anything anytime. God hears you.
You